If our brain and our thoughts determine how we live and how healthy we live, how do we gain more control over our brain and everything our brain produces? How do we accelerate the development from a fixed mindset to a growth mindset? As already discussed, seeking mental peace plays a key role in this development. Taking a break every day teaches us to recognize automated behaviors and thoughts faster and faster, and let our body benefit more from restorative and resistance hormones instead of negative hormones. In this way, we're getting better and better at conditioning our programmed brain in a consciously positive way. Interestingly, this learning process can be accelerated through conditioning exercises. Because everything we do, think, and imagine is ultimately added to the data in our subconscious, to our lifestyle library, through this process. And that, in turn, determines how we function on a daily basis. A first important accelerator of this process is dwell more often on what we want instead of the automated negative behavior or thoughts we have. Like one of Byron Katie's questions, what would you be like without those thoughts or without those behaviors? The more time and space you give to that question, the more a new blueprint develops that weakens existing negative, conditioned patterns. A second strategy that can also give an extra acceleration is imagining or visualizing yourself that you're already applying those desirable thoughts or behavior. Our subconscious sees almost no difference between actually doing something and only the visualization of doing it. So imagine yourself a little more often that you already think and act differently. Because people often say, first see, then believe. But it turns out to work just the other way around. We have to believe in something before we see it reflected in our daily lives. As a third strategy, when doing a visualization exercise and imagining yourself doing what you want to do, you can also try to feel what it does to you. How does it feel when you let go of that limiting thought and apply those empowering thoughts? What is the effect on your behavior, on your feelings, on your self-esteem, on your lifestyle and health? The more connection you make between what you want, your head, and how you feel about it, your heart, the stronger the imprint is on your subconscious, and the faster you develop from a fixed mindset to a growth mindset. Your subconscious is eager to continue with thoughts that feel pleasant. A fourth supportive strategy to develop faster is to do this together with someone. By doing something together, you often strengthen each other's motivation. Another can help you remember your goal or help you achieve it. You can share with someone what you're working on or encounter. We therefore cordially invite you to share this series with someone you love. Then, you could do this process of awareness and change to healthier, perhaps together with someone or even with a group. For example, form a new health group, review the introduction and all three parts together, and determine a goal together for the coming months. Then watch one of the parts of this mind series each week and discuss how this is going in your group. What do you encounter? What do you like? What keeps you busy? And how can you support each other? A fifth strategy is to realize that the daily grind and stimuli from your environment, in combination with our programmed brain and all fixed thinking patterns, will do everything to keep you stuck in your habitual behavior. Our ego comes to the aid of the subconscious, and before you know it, you've either forgotten your intention or you have so many arguments again that you fall back because of it. So stay alert, especially the first 2 to 3 months of the change, and remind yourself of what you want to achieve and do. We call this self-nudging, or putting triggers in our daily life that helps us remember what we've planned. For example, hang a note on your wall, write down before you go to sleep what you want to work on tomorrow, or put a bowl of fruit on the table instead of cookies. And if your brain starts calling out thoughts that don't help you again, try seeing them as a distraction. You hear them calling all the time, but you don't have to answer them. You may just continue working on your new goal. What can we learn from this? Regularly stop and think, what do I want with this? Feel free to visualize more often what you do want and what it looks like, instead of what you don't want. Take on lifestyle challenges with someone else. We all want to live a healthy life and age healthily. So how do we use what we've just learned in our daily lives so that we can reap the benefits for a lifetime? We'll discuss this in the last chapter.